So this is lecture 52 according to your lesson plan, and in this lecture we are going to discuss about the relation between the continuous and discrete time system. Okay, so we had already a lot of discussion on this topic, that the how we are going to convert this continuous signal into digital signal or continuous signal to into discrete signal. Okay, so obviously a system, if it is working on a continuous time signal, this system will be a continuous system. Okay, and if it is working on the discrete signal, so it will be known as the discrete system. So if you want to find out the relation between this continuous and discrete system, it will reflect as it is same when you are comparing the your continuous time signal and discrete time signal. Okay, so that's why I told you we had already a lot of discussion on this continuous and discrete time signal. Now I'm just going to directly write down this. Okay, suppose you have, for example, if you have a continuous time signal, okay, and you want to use this continuous time signal in a discrete time system. Okay, so you have input is XT, let's say this is XT, and this XT is continuous time signal, and you want to use this signal in any discrete time signal. So what you have to do? Obviously you have to convert this XT signal into a discrete time signal. So for that purpose you have to use the converter, first thing, or you can do the sampling over here. So sampled signal होगा वो आप डायरेक्ट डिस्क्रीट सिस्टम में यूज कर सकते हैं, एंड फर्दर वहां पे आप उसको प्रोसेस करा सकते हैं. नाउ अगर मैं आपसे बोलू डिस्क्रीट टाइम प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ कंटिन्यूस time signals, and you want to draw this block diagram of this, so obviously you have to use the converter over here. After converter, you will send your message signal into a discrete time system, and again you have to convert this into a continuous time signal. Okay, so we will see, let's see this C to D conversion, discrete time system, and D to C conversion here. This signal is XCT. I am using XCT means continuous. Here, after converging, obviously you will get the digital signal XDN. Okay, or if you want to represent in term of continuous, so you can write it down XCNT. So N is the number of samples, or T जो उसका है क्या है sampling period. After passing through this discrete time system, let's see, you are getting the YDN output signal, and that is the representation in terms of the and the CFT. So this is the generalized system, okay, a block diagram of a discrete system, okay, where you are giving the input is XCT, that is continuous. After continuous, you have to use the conversion converter. So you have converted this continuous time signal into digital signal. Okay, you can use the discrete also, because in C to D, okay, you can use rather than this digital. Okay, analog to A to D, as you know, this A to D converter and D to A converter. Okay, analog. This to converter, I am just using here C to D converter. So you can use the your continuous to discrete. okay, and how we can convert this continuous to discrete with the help of the sampling. So I am using here C to D conversion. So after converting, we are getting this XDN, okay, number of samples values हमें मिल गई. And if you want to in the form of C continuous, so this NT we are using. N is number of samples and T is the time period. Why we are doing this? Because this discrete time system, it will operate only, or it will work only on the your discrete time signal. If you are having discrete time signal, then it will work. Okay, obviously, as you know, okay, agar main aapse bolta hun, okay, let's see, you want to work on a Arduino. Arduino mein hame pata hai, if suppose we want to give this input signal, and that input signal in the form of the digital 1 and 0, तो उसके पहले क्या करते हैं, हम A to D कन्वर्टर लगाते हैं. अगर हम कन्वर्टर नहीं लगाते हैं तो माइक्रो प्रोसेसर को कुछ समझ में ही नहीं आता, सॉरी माइक्रो कंट्रोलर को, कि आप उसे कमांड क्या दे रहे हैं, इंस्ट्रक्शन क्या दे रहे हैं. सो जो सिस्टम जिस प्रॉपर्टीज पे बना हुआ है, उसमें हमें उसी प्रॉपर्टी का सिग्नल एज ए इनपुट देना पड़ेगा. सो लेट्स सी, एट द आउटपुट साइड वी आर गेटिंग दिस YDN, आउटपुट ऑफ दिस डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिस्टम, ओके, और YC, that is the number of samples जो लिया है, उन samples के according output पे क्या values मिल रही. And obviously, अगर output पे देखें, you have again required the continuous time signal, so use the your discrete to continuous conversion over here, YCNT. So this is actually a flow diagram, a block diagram of any your system. If you want to process your continuous time signal into a discrete time system, अब अगर मैं बोलूं कि हम कन्वर्जन करते थे, तो ऑब्वियसली इसी के करस्पोंडिंग अगर मैं आपको डायग्राम बनाना चाहूं, ब्लॉक डायग्राम, सो ऑल ऑफ यू हैव सीन दिस, वी हैव टू डू द सैंपलिंग ओवर हियर. सो दिस इज इनपुट, दिस इज द योर सैंपल फंक्शन PT, दिस इज योर XT. And here we are getting the XPT sampled function. And this sampled function, you have to, means एक तरह से क्या, after sampling, एक तरह से क्या कर रहे हैं, conversion ही कर रहे हैं. Samples का मतलब क्या हुआ, कि converted value मिल गया, but this conversion should be your according to your impulse response of the your system. So this conversion of impulse train to discrete time sequence, and after that you will get the this XDN, okay, whatever we are receiving here, okay. So this conversion C to D is taking here this place, means you have to use the impulse function also. So this is nothing else the C to D conversion, okay. We are not going to draw this impulse response because we have already seen in a lecture, okay, in unit number 1 when we were discussing about this your analog to digital conversion. Now, so if I want to draw the overall signal, okay, overall according to this simple block diagram, what will be, we have XT, यहां पे क्या मिल रहा था, XPT कन्वर्जन ऑफ, आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग डिस्क्रीट टाइम एज ए डीटी सीक्वेंस टू इंपल्स ट्रेन. आफ्टर दैट वी वर गेटिंग द ये वाला डायग्राम XDN, इस एक्सडीएन को आप किससे पास करा रहे थे? डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिस्टम से. सो यू आर यूजिंग हियर डीटी सिस्टम, दैट इज डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिस्टम, एंड उसका जो फंक्शन है वो क्या है? एच डी ई टू एच डी जे ओमेगा. ओके, जो उसका ट्रांसफर फंक्शन है वो मीन्स एच स्मॉल एच डी टी इन टाइम डोमेन, बट हियर वी आर राइटिंग इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन, सो एच डी जे ओमेगा. ओके, आफ्टर दैट वी वर गेटिंग दिस वाई डी एन, सो वी हैव टू जो मिल रहा था वो हमें मिल रहा था वाई डी एन. अगेन यू हैव टू यूज द कन्वर्जन ओवर हेयर. ओके, सो दैट विल बी योर कन्वर्जन ऑफ की टाइम सिक्वेंस, दिस इज योर डी टी सिक्वेंस टू इम्पल्स ट्रेन, and after that you will get this ypt, and at the end you have to pass this with the your filter. So let's see, this is your filter response omega, this is jo hum baat kar rahe the omega s by 2 omega s by 2, this is your H of G omega, जो हमने प्रीवियस लेक्चर में देखा था, एंड आफ्टर दैट यू विल गेट द YCT. सो दिस इज योर ओवरऑल सिस्टम फॉर डिस्क्रीट टाइप प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ द कंटीन्यूअस टाइम सिग्नल. मींस द सिस्टम इज डिस्क्रीट टाइम, बट यू आर गोइंग टू प्रोसेस योर सिग्नल एज ए कंटीन्यूअस टाइम सिग्नल. ओके, सो दीज स्टेप्स यू हैव टू फॉलो व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू process your continuous time signal into a digital signal. So it's showing the relation between how this C to D and D to C conversion is useful in the case of these discrete time, or you can suppose you have a continuous time signal and you are on this D signal, so that will be in opposite. ओके, सो सी टी टू डी की जगह पर आप क्या जाएगा, इफ यू हैव डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल यू वांट टू प्रोसेस इनटू अ कंटीन्यूअस टाइम सिस्टम. ओके, सो ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू डू डी टू सी कन्वर्जन एट द इनपुट साइड, एंड इसके जो अपोजिट होगा वो आपको रिसीवर एंड पे और एट द आउटपुट एंड यू हैव टू यूज दिस कन्वर्जन ओवर देयर. ओके,